Hello, Namaste. Myself Ankita Shreya Prasad, and you are listening to along with our NCERT 11th and 12th audio video book presented by Artskill Passion.
Unit 1: Some basic concepts of chemistry. Science can be viewed as continuing human effort to systemize knowledge of describing and understanding nature. You have learned it in your previous classes that we come across diverse substances present in nature and changes in them in daily life. Curd formation from milk, formation of vinegar from sugarcane juice on keeping for prolonged time, and rusting of iron are some of the examples of changes which we come across many times. For the sake of convenience, science is thus subdivided into various disciplines: chemistry, physics, biology, geology, etc. The branch of science that studies the preparation, properties, structure, and reactions of material substances is called chemistry. Development of chemistry. Chemistry, as we understand it today, is not a very old discipline. Chemistry was not studied for its own sake, rather it came up as a result of search for two interesting things. One, philosopher's stone, paras, which would convert all basal metals, example iron and copper, into gold. Second, elixir of life, which would grant mortality. People in ancient India already had the knowledge of many scientific phenomena much before the advent of modern science. They applied the knowledge in various walks of life. Chemistry developed mainly in the form of alchemy and hydrochemistry during 1300 to 1600 CE. Modern chemistry took shape in the 18th century Europe. After a few centuries of alchemical traditions which were introduced in Europe by the Arabs. Other countries, especially Chinese and Indian, had their own alchemical traditions. These include much knowledge of chemical processes and techniques. In ancient India, chemistry was called Rasayan Shastra, Ras Tantra, Ras Kriya, or Ras Vidya. It includes metallurgy, medicine, manufacture of cosmetics, glass, dyeing, etc. Systematic excavations are at Mohenjo-daro in Sindh and Harappa in Punjab prove that the story of development of chemistry in India is very old. Archaeological findings shows that baked bricks were used in construction work. It shows the mass production of pottery, which can be regarded as the earliest chemical process, in which the materials were mixed, molded, and subjected to heat by using fire to achieve desirable quantities. Remains of pottery have been found in Mohenjo-daro. Gypsum cement has been used in the construction work. It contains lime, sand, traces of CaCO3, Harappan's mead. Faience, a sort of glass which was used in ornaments. They melted and forged a variety of objects from metal such as lead, silver, gold, and copper. They improved the hardness of copper by making artifacts by using the tin and arsenics. A number of glass objects were found in Maski in South India, 1000 to 900 BC, and Hastinapur and Taxila in North India from 1000 to 200 BCE. Glass and glazes were colored by tradition of coloring agents like metal oxides. Copper metallurgy in India dates back to the beginning of Chalcolithic culture in the subcontinent. There are much archaeological evidences to support the view that technologies for extraction of copper and iron were developed indigenously. According to Rig Veda, tanning of leather and dyeing of cotton were practiced during 1000 to 400 BC. The golden gloss of the black polished ware of northern India could not be replicated and is still a chemical mystery. These wares indicate the mastery with which chilling temperatures could be controlled. Kautilya's Arthashastra described the production of salt from sea. A vast number of statements and materials described in the ancient Vedic literature can be shown to agree with modern scientific findings. Copper utensils, iron, gold, silver ornaments are terracotta disc and painted grey pottery has been found in many archaeological sites in India. Sushruta Samhita explains the importance of alkalis. The Chakra Samhita mentions ancient Indians who knew how to prepare sulfuric acid, nitric acid, and oxides of copper, tin, and zinc. The sulfates of copper, zinc, and iron, and the carbonates of lead and iron. Rasopanishada describes the preparation of gunpowder mixture. The Tamil text also describes the preparation of fireworks using sulfur, charcoal, saltpeter, that is potassium nitrate, mercury, camphor, etc. Nagarjuna was a great Indian scientist. He was a reputed chemist and an alchemist. A metallurgist, his work, Ras Ratnakar, deals with the formation of mercury compounds. He also discussed methods for extractions of metals like gold, silver, tin, copper. A book, Rasan Navam, appeared around 800 CE. It discussed the uses of various furnaces. Ovens are crucibles for different purposes. It describes method by which metals could be identified by flame color. Chakrapani discovered mercury sulfide. The credit of inventing soap also goes to him. He also used mustard oil and some alkalis as ingredient for making soap. Indians began making soap in 18th century CE. Oil of Ernada and seeds of Mahu plant and calcium carbonate were used for making soap. The paintings found on the walls of Ajanta and Ellora, which took fresh even after ages, testifying to high level of science achieved in ancient India. Varahamihir's Virat Samhita is a sort of encyclopedia which was composed in the 6th century CE. It informs about the preparation of gelatinous materials to be appeared on walls and roofs of houses and temples. It was prepared entirely from extracts of various plants, fruits, seeds and bark, which were concentrated by boiling and then treated with various resins. It will be interesting to test such materials scientifically and assess them for us. A number of classical texts like Atharveda from 1000 BCE mention some dye stuff. The material used were turmeric, madder, sunflower, cochineal and lac. Some other substances having tinting property were Camphrisica, Pathanga and Jatuka. Varahamihir's Virat Samhita gives references to perfumes and cosmetics. Recipes of hair drying were made from plants like indigo and minerals like iron powder, black iron or steel and acidic extracts of sour rice, burel. Gandayukhili describes recipes for making scents, mouth perfumes, bath powders, incenses, and talcum powder. Paper was known in India in 17th century as account of Chinese traveler. Eitzing described excavations at Taxila indicate that ink was used in India from the 4th century. Colors of ink were made from chalk, red lead and minium. It seems that the process of fermentation was well known to Indians. Vedas and Kautilya's Arthashastra mention about many types of liquors. Charaka Samhita also mention ingredients such as bags of plant stem, flowers, leaves, woods, cereals, fruits and sugar cane for making asavas. The concept that matter is ultimately made of indivisible building blocks appeared in India a few centuries BCE as a part of philosophical speculations. Acharya Khanda, born in 600 BCE, originally known by the name Kashyapa, was the first proponent of atomic theory. He formulated the theory of very small indivisible particles, which he named Paramanu, comparable to atoms. He authored the text Vaisheshika Sutra. According to him, all substances are aggregated from of smaller units called atoms, paramanu, which are internal, indestructible, spherical, suprasensible and in motion in the original state. He explained that this individual entity cannot be sensed through any human organ. Khanda added that there are varieties of atoms that are as different as the different classes of substances. He said these paramanus could form pairs of triplets among other combinations and unseen forces cause interaction between them. He conceptualized this theory around 2500 years before John Dalton. 1766-2844. Charaka Samhita is the oldest Ayurveda epic of India. It describes the treatment of diseases. The concept of reduction of particle size of metals is clearly discussed in Charaka Samhita. Extreme reduction of particle size is termed as nanotechnology. Charaka Samhita describes the use of bhasma of metals in treatment of ailments. Nowadays, it has been proved that bhasmas have nanoparticles of metals. After the decline of alchemy, iatrogenic chemistry related to steady state, but it too declined due to the introduction and practices of Western medicinal system in the 20th century. During this period of stagnation, pharmaceutical industry based on Ayurveda continued to exist, but it too declined gradually. It took about 100 to 150 years of Indians to learn and adopt new techniques. During this time, foreign products poured in. As a result, indigenous tradition technique gradually declined. Modern science appeared in Indian sense in the later part of the 19th century. By the mid-19th century, European scientists started coming to India and modern chemistry started growing. From the above discussion, you have learned that chemistry deals with the composition structure, properties and interactions of matter and is of much use to human beings in daily life. These aspects can be best described and understood in terms of basic constituents of matter that are atoms and molecules. That is why chemistry is also called science of atoms and molecules. Can we see, weigh and receive these entities, atoms and molecules. Is it possible to count the number of atoms and molecules in a given mass of matter and have quantitative relationship between the mass and the number of these particles? We will get the answer of some of these questions in this unit. We will further describe how physical properties of matter can be quantitatively described using numerical values with suitable units. Importance of chemistry. Chemistry plays a central role in science and is often intertwined with other branches of science. Principles of chemistry are applicable in diverse areas such as weather pattern, functioning of brain and operation of computer, production in chemical industries, manufacturing fertilizers, alkalis, acids, salts, dyes, polymers, drugs, soaps, detergents, metals, alloys, etc., including new material. Chemistry contributed in big way to national economy. It also played an important role in meeting human needs for food, healthcare products and other material aimed at improving the quality of life. This is exemplified by the large-scale production of variety of fertilizers, improved variety of pesticides and insecticides. Chemistry provides methods for the isolation of life, saving drugs from natural sources and make possible synthesis of such drugs. Some of these drugs are cisplatin and taxol, which are effective in cancer therapy. The drug AZT, azidothymidine, is used for helping AIDS patients. Chemistry contributed to a large extent in the development and growth of a nation. With a better understanding of chemical principles, it has now become possible to design and synthesize new materials having specific magnetic, electric, and optical properties. This had led to the production of superconducting ceramics, conducting polymers, optical fibers, etc. Chemistry has helped in establishing industries which manufacture utility goods like aids, alkalines, dyes, polymer metals, etc. These industries contribute in a big way to economy of a nation and generate employment. In recent years, chemistry has helped in dealing with some of the pressing aspects of environmental degradation with a great degree of success. Safer alternatives to environmentally hazardous refrigerants like CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons, responsible for ozone depletion in the stratosphere, have been successfully synthesized. However, many big environmental problems continue to be matters of grave concern to the chemists. One such problem is the management of the greenhouse gases like methane, carbon dioxide, etc. Understanding of biochemical processes, use of enzymes for large-scale production of chemicals and synthesis of new exotic materials are some of the intellectual challenges for the future generation of chemists. A developing country like India needs talented and creative chemists. For accepting such challenges, to be a good chemist and to accept such challenges, one needs to understand the basic concepts of chemistry, which begin with the concepts of matter. Let us start with the nature of matter. 1.2. Nature of matter. You are already familiar with the term matter from your earlier classes. Anything which has mass and occupies space is called matter. Everything around us, for example, book, pen, pencil, water, air, all living beings, etc., are composed of matter. You know that they have mass and they occupy space. Let us recall the characteristics of the states of matter, which you learned in your previous classes. 1.2.1 states of matter. You are aware that matter can exist in three physical states: solid, liquid, and gases. The constituent particles of matter in these three states can be represented as shown in Figure 1.1. Arrangement of particles in solid, liquid, and gaseous state. Particles are held very close to each other in solids in an ordinary fashion, and there is no much freedom of movement. In liquids, the particles are close to each other, but they can move around. However, in gases, the particles are far apart as compared to those present in solid or liquid states, and their movement is easy and fast. Because of such arrangement of particles, different states of matter exhibit the following characteristics. Solids have definite volume and definite shape. Liquids have definite volume but do not have definite shape. They take the shape of container in which they are placed. Gases have neither definite volume nor definite shape. They completely occupy the space in the container in which they are placed. These three states of matter are interconvertible by changing the conditions of temperature and pressure. Solid converts to liquid in the presence of heat. Liquid convert to gases in the presence of heat. Gases converted into liquids by the presence of coolness. Liquid is converted to solid by the presence of coolness. On heating, a solid usually changes to a liquid, and the liquid on further heating changes to gas or vapor. In the reverse process, a gas on cooling liquefies to the liquid, and the liquid on further cooling freezes to the solid. 1.2.2 Classification of matter. In class 9, chapter 2, you have learned that at the macroscopic or bulk level, matter can be classified as mixture or two substances. These can be further subdivided as Figure 1.2. Classification of matter. Matter is divided into mixture and two substances. Mixtures. Mixture is divided into homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixtures. Pure substances. It is divided into elements and compounds. When all constituent particles of a substance are same in chemical nature, it is said to be a pure substance. A mixture contains many types of particles. A mixture contains particles of two or more substances which may be present in it in any ratio. Hence, their composition is variable. Few substances forming mixtures are called its components. Many of the substances present around you are mixtures. For example, sugar solution in water, air, tea, etc. are all mixtures. A mixture may be homogeneous or heterogeneous. In a homogeneous mixture, the component completely mix with each other. This means particles of components of the mixture are uniformly distributed throughout the bulk of the mixture, and its composition is uniform throughout. Sugar solution and air are the example of homogeneous mixtures. In contrast to this, in a heterogeneous mixture, the composition is not uniformly throughout and sometimes different. Components are visible. For example, mixture of salt and sugar, grains and pulses along with some dirt, often stone pieces, are heterogeneous mixtures. You can think of many more examples of mixtures which you come across in daily life. It is worthwhile to mention here that the components of a mixture can be separated by using physical methods such as simple hand picking, filtration, crystallization, distillation, etc. Two substances have characteristics different from mixtures. Constituent particles of pure substances have fixed composition. Copper, silver, gold, water and glucose are some examples of pure substances. Glucose contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen in a fixed ratio and its particles are of same composition. Hence, like all other pure substances, glucose has a fixed composition. Also, its constituent carbon, hydrogen, oxygen cannot be separated by simple physical methods. Pure substances can be classified into elements and compounds. Particles of an element consist of only one type of atoms. These particles may exist as atoms or molecules. You may be familiar with atoms and molecules from the previous classes. However, you will be studying about them in detail in Unit 2. Sodium, copper, silver, hydrogen, oxygen, etc. are some examples of elements. There all atoms are of one type. However, the atoms of different elements are different in nature. Some elements such as sodium or copper contain atoms as their constituent particles, whereas in some other. The constituent particles are molecules which are formed by two or more atoms. For example, hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen gases constitute of molecules in which two atoms combine to give their respective molecules. This is illustrated in figure 1.3. Figure 1.3 representation of atoms and molecules. Atoms of different elements HONCUNA. An atom of hydrogen H. Another atom of hydrogen H. Combined to form a molecule of hydrogen H2. An atom of oxygen O plus another atom of oxygen O combined to form a molecule of oxygen O2. When two or more atoms of different elements combine together in a definite ratio, the molecules of a compound is obtained. Moreover, the constituent of a compound cannot be separated into simpler substances by physical methods. They can be separated by chemical methods. Examples of some compounds are water, ammonia, carbon dioxide, sugar, etc. The molecules of water and carbon dioxide are represented in figure 1.4. Figure 1.4, a duplication of molecules of water and carbon dioxide. Water molecule H2O, carbon dioxide molecule CO2. Note that a water molecule comprises two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. Similarly, a molecule of carbon dioxide contains two oxygen atoms combined with carbon atom. Thus, the atoms of different elements are present in a compound in a fixed and definite ratio. This ratio is characteristics of particular compound. Also, the properties of a compound are different from those of its constituent elements. For example, hydrogen and oxygen are gases, whereas the compound formed by their combination, that is, water, is a liquid. It is interesting to note that hydrogen burns with a pop sound and oxygen is supporter of composition, but water is used as a fire extinguisher. 1.3. Properties of matter and their measurement. 1.3.1. Physical and chemical properties. Every substance has unique or characteristic properties. These properties can be classified into two categories. Physical properties such as color, odor, melting point, boiling point, density, etc. And chemical properties like composition, combustibility, reactivity with acids and bases, etc. Physical properties can be measured or observed without changing the identity or composition of the substance. The measurement or observation of chemical properties require a chemical change to occur. Measurement of physical properties does not require occurrence of a chemical change. The example of chemical properties are characteristic reaction of different substances. These include acidity or basicity or combustibility, etc. Chemists describe, interpret and predict the behavior of substances on the basis of knowledge of their physical and chemical properties, which are determined by careful measurement and experimentation. In the following section, we will learn about the measurement of physical properties. 1.3.2 Measurement of physical properties. Quantitative measurement of properties is required for scientific investigation. Many properties of matter, such as length, area, volume, etc., are quantitative in nature. Any quantitative observation or measurement is represented by a number followed by units in which it is measured. For example, length of a room can be represented as 6 meter. Here, 6 is the number and m denotes meter, the unit in which the length is measured. Earlier, two different systems of measurement, that is English system and metric system, were being used in different parts of the world. The metric system, which originated in France in late 18th century, was more convenient and as it was based on the decimal system. Late need of a common standard system was felt by the scientific community. Such a system was established in 1916 and is discussed in detail below. 1.3.3 The International System of Units, SI. The International System of Units, in French, Le Système International des Units, abbreviated as SI, was established by 11th General Conference on Weights and Measurement, CGPM, from Conference Générale des Poids et Mesures. The CGPM is an intergovernmental treaty or organization created by diplomatic treaty known as Mitre Convention, which was signed in Paris in 1875. The SI system has 7 base units and their table 1.1. Base physical quantities and their units. Base physical quantities, next symbol for quantity and name of SI unit and symbol of SI unit. Length, L, SI unit meter, symbol M. Mass, M, SI unit kilogram, kg. Time, T, SI unit seconds, S. Electric current, I. SI unit ampere, A. Thermodynamic temperature, T. SI unit Kelvin, K. Amount of substance, N. SI unit mole, mol. Luminous intensity, I, V. SI unit candela, CD. These units pertain to the 7 fundamental scientific quantities. The other physical quantities, such as speed, volume, density, etc., can be derived from these quantities. The definition of SI base units are given in table 1.2. Table 1.2, definition of SI base units. Units of length, meter. The meter is the length of path traveled by light in vacuum during a time travel of 1 divided by 299792458 of a second. Unit of mass, kilogram. The kilogram is the unit of mass. It is equal to the mass of international prototype of the kilogram. Unit of time, second. The second is the duration of 9192631770. Period of the radiation corresponding to the transition between the two hyperfine levels of the ground state of the cesium 133rd atom. Unit of electric current, ampere. The ampere is that constant current which is, if maintained in two straight parallel conductors of infinite length of negligible circular cross section and placed 1 meter apart in vacuum, would produce between these conductors a force equal to 2×10⁻⁷ Newton per meter of length. Unit of thermodynamic temperature, Kelvin. The Kelvin unit of thermodynamic temperature is the fraction 1 divided by 273.16 of the thermodynamic temperature of the triple point of water. Triple point of water is 0.01 degree Celsius or 279.1 K, 32.01 degree Fahrenheit. Unit of amount of substance, mole. The mole is the amount of substance of a system which contains as many elementary entities as there are atoms in 0.012 kilogram of carbon will, its symbol is mole. When the mole is used, the elementary entities must be specified, and these may be atoms, molecules, ions, electrons, other particles, or specified group of such particles. Unit of luminous intensity, candela. The candela is the luminous intensity in a given direction of a source that emits monochromatic radiation of frequency 540×10⁻½ Hz, and that has radiant intensity in the direction of 1 divided by 683 watt per steradian. The SI system allows the use of prefixes to indicate the multiples or submultiples of a unit. These prefixes are listed in Table 1.3. Table 1.3, prefixes used in the SI system. Multiple prefix symbol. Multiple 10⁻², the octo, Y. 10⁻², septo, Z. 10⁻¹⁸, atto, A. 10⁻¹⁵, femto, F. 10⁻¹⁻, pico, P. 10⁻⁹, nano, N. 10⁻⁶, micro. 10⁻⁶, micro, mu. 10⁻³, milli, M. 10⁻², centi, C. 10⁻⁹, deci, B. 10, deca, da. 10⁻² hecto, H. 10⁻³, kilo, K. 10⁻⁶, mega, M. 10⁻⁹, giga, G. 10⁻½, tetra, T. 10⁻⁵, peta, P. 10⁻⁸, hexa, E. 10⁻⁶, zeta, Z. 10⁻⁴, yocta, Y. Let us now quickly go through some of the quantities which you will be often using in this book. 1.3.4, mass and weight. Mass of a substance is the amount of matter present in it, while weight is the force exerted by gravity on an object. The mass of a substance is constant, whereas its weight may vary from one place to another due to change in gravity. You should be careful using these terms. The mass of a substance can be determined accurately in laboratory by using an analytical balance. Figure 1.5 analytical balance. Rider carrier knob, pointer and scale, beam release, pan release, leveling screw, pan, beam. The SI unit of mass as given in table 1.1 is kilogram. However, its fraction named as gram, 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram, is used in laboratories due to the smaller amount of chemicals used in chemical reactions. 1.3.5 Volume. Volume is the amount of space occupied by a substance. It has the unit of length to the power of 3. Volume has unit of meter cube. But again, in chemistry laboratories, smaller volumes are used. Hence, volume is often denoted in centimeter cube or decimeter cube units. A common unit, liter L, which is not a SI unit. It is used for measurement of volume of liquids. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. 1000 centimeter cube is equal to 1 decameter cube. Figure 1.6 helps to visualize the relations. Volume 1000 centimeter cube is equal to 1000 ml, 1 decameter cube, 1 liter. 10 centimeter is equal to 1 decameter. Volume is equal to 1 centimeter cube equal to 1 milliliter. In the laboratory, the volume of liquids or solutions can be measured by graduated cylinder, burette, pipette, etc. A volumetric flask is used to prepare a known volume of a solution. These measuring devices are shown in Figure 1.7. Some volume measuring devices: burette, pipette, graduated cylinder, volumetric flask. 1.3.6 Density. The two properties, mass and volume, discussed above are related as follows. Density is equal to mass by volume. Density of a substance is its amount of mass per unit volume. So SI unit of density can be obtained as follows. SI unit of density is equal to SI unit of mass by SI unit of volume is equal to kg meter cube or kg is equal to kg meter cube or kg meter into the power of minus 3. This unit is quite large and a chemist often expresses density in grams or centimeter minus cube. Where mass is expressed in gram and volume is expressed in centimeter to the power of 3. Density of substance tells us about how closely particles are packed. If density is more, it means particles are more closely packed. 1.3.7 Temperature. There are three common scales to measure temperature: degree C, degree Celsius, degree F, degree Fahrenheit, and K, Kelvin. Here K is the SI unit. The thermometer based on these scales are shown in Figure 1.8. Figure 1.8. Thermometers using different temperature scales: Kelvin, Celsius, Fahrenheit. Generally, the thermometer with Celsius scale are calibrated from 0 degree to 100 degree, where these two temperatures are the freezing point and the boiling point of water, respectively. The Fahrenheit scale is represented between 32 degrees to 212 degrees. The temperature on two scales are related to each other by the following relationship. Degree Fahrenheit is equal to 9/5 degrees Celsius plus 32. The Kelvin scale is related to Celsius scale as follows. K is equal to degree Celsius plus 273.15. It is interesting to note that temperature below 0 degree Celsius, that is negative values, are possible in Celsius scale, but in Kelvin scale negative temperature are not possible. 1.4. Uncertainty in measurement. Many a time in the study of chemistry, one has to deal with experimental data as well as theoretical calculation. There are meaningful ways to handle the numbers conventionally, and presence of the data realistically with certainty to the extent possible. These ideas are discussed below in detail. 1.4.1. Scientific notation. As chemistry is the study of atoms and molecules which have extremely low masses and are present in extremely large numbers, a chemist has to deal with numbers as large as 60 to 200 000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 as 0.000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 Similarly, other constants such as Planck's constant, speed of light, charges on particles, etc. involve numbers of the above magnitude. It may look funny for a moment to write or count numbers involving so many zeros, but it offers a real change to do simple mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication or division with such numbers. You can write any two numbers of the above type and try any one of the operation you like to accept as a challenge, and then you will really appreciate the difficulty in handling such numbers. This problem is solved by using scientific notation for such numbers, that is exponential notation, in which any numbers can be represented in the form of n into 10 to the power of n, where n is an exponent having positive or negative values, and n is a number called digit term which varies between 1.0002 and 9.999 goes. Thus, we can write 232.508 as 2.32508 into the 10 to the power of 2 in scientific notation. Note that while writing it, the decimal had to be moved to the left by 2 places, and same as the exponent 2 of 10 in the scientific notation. Similarly, 0.00016 can be written as 1.6 into the 10 to the power of minus 4. Here the decimal has to be moved 4 places to right, and minus 4 is the exponent in the scientific notation. While performing mathematical operations on numbers expressed in scientific notation, the following points are to be kept in mind. Multiplication and division. These two operations follow the same rules which are there for exponential number, that is 5.6 into the 10 to the power of 5 into 6.9 into the 10 to the power of 8 is equal to 5.6 into 6.9 bracket 10 to the power of 5 plus 8 is equal to 5.6 into 6.9 into 10 power 13 is equal to 38.64 into 10 to the power of 13 is equal to 3.864 into 10 to the power of 14. 9.8 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 6 is equal to 9.8 into 2.5 bracket 10 to the power of minus 2 plus of minus 6 is equal to 9.8 into 2.5 bracket 10 to the power of minus 2 minus 6 is equal to 24.50 into 10 power minus 8 is equal to 2.450 into 10 to the power of minus 7. 2.7 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 5.5 into 10 to the power of 4 is equal to 2.7 divided by 5.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3 minus 4 is equal to 0.4909 into 10 to the power of minus 7 is equal to 4.909 into 10 to the power of minus 8. Addition and subtraction. For these two operations, first the numbers are written in such a way that they have the same exponent. After that, the coefficients, digit terms are added or subtracted as the case may be. Thus, for adding 6.65 into 10 to the power of 4 and 8.95 into the 10 to the power of 3 exponent is made. Same for both the numbers. Thus, we get 6.65 into 10 to the power of 4 plus 0.895 into 10 to the power of 4. Then these numbers can be added as follows. 6.65 plus 0.895 into 10 to the power of 4 is equal to 7.545 into 10 to the power of 4. Similarly, the subtractions of two numbers can be done as shown below. 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 minus of 4.8 into 10 to the power of minus 3 is equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 minus of 0.48 into 10 to the power of minus 2 is equal to 2.5 minus 0.48 into 10 to the power of minus 2 is equal to 2.02 into 10 power minus 2. 1.4.2 significant figures. Every experimental measurement has some amount of uncertainty associated with it. Because of limitation of measuring instrument and the skill of the person making the measurement. For example, mass of an object is obtained using a platform balance and it comes out to be 9.4 gram. On measuring the mass of this object on an analytical balance, the mass obtained is 9.4213 gram. The mass obtained by an analytical balance is slightly higher than the mass obtained by using platform balance. Therefore, digit 4 placed after decimal in the measurement by platform balance is uncertain. The uncertainty in the experimental or the calculated values is indicated by mentioning the numbers of significant figures. Significant figures are meaningful digits which are known with the certainty plus 1 which is estimated or uncertain. The uncertainty is indicated by writing the certain digits and the lost uncertain digit. Thus, if we write a result as 11.2 mL, we say the 11 is certain and 2 is uncertain. And the uncertainty would be plus or minus 1 in the last digit. Unless otherwise stated, an uncertainty of plus or minus 1 is the last digit is always understood. There are certain rules for determining the number of significant figures. These are stated below. All the non-zero digits are significant. For example, in 285 centimeter, there are 3 significant figures, and in 0.25 ml, there are 2 significant figures. Second, zeros preceding to first non-zero digits are non-significant. Such zeros indicate the position of decimal point. Thus, 0.03 has 1 significant figure and 0.0052 has 2 significant figures. Third, zeros between two non-zero digits are significant. Thus, 2.005 has 4 significant figures. Fourth, zeros at the end or right of a number are significant. provided they are on the right side of the decimal point. For example, 0.200 gram has three significant figures. But if otherwise the terminal zeros are not significant, if there is no decimal point. For example, 100 has only one significant figures, but 100 has three significant figures and 100.0 has four significant figures. Such numbers are better represented in scientific notation. We can express the number 100 as 1 into 10 to the power of 2 for 1 significant figures, 1.0 into 10 to the power of 2 for 2 significant figures, and 1.00 into 10 to the power of 2 for 3 significant figures. Fifth, counting the numbers of objects. For example, 2 balls or 20 eggs have infinite significant figures, as these are exact numbers and can be represented by writing infinite number of zeros after placing a decimal, that is 2 is equal to 2.000000, or 20 is equal to 20.000000. In numbers written in scientific notation, all digits are significant. Example, 4.01 into 10 to the power of 2 has 3 significant figures, and 8.256 into 10 to the power of minus 3 has 4 significant figures. However, one would always like the result to be precise and accurate. Precision and accuracy are often referred to while we talk about the measurement. Precision refers to the closeness of various measurements for the same quantity. However, accuracy is the agreement of a particular value to the true value of the result. For example, if the true value of a result is 2.00 gram and student A takes two measurements and reports the result as 1.95 gram and 1.93 gram, these values are precise as they are close to each other but are not accurate. Another student B represents the experiment and obtains 1.94 gram and 2.05 gram as the result for two measurements. These observations are neither precise nor accurate. When the third student C repeats these measurements and report 2.01 gram and 1.99 gram as the result, these values are both precise and accurate. This can be more clearly understood from the data given below in table 1.4. Data to illustrate precision and accuracy. Measurement by gram. Student A 1.95, second 1.93, average grams 1.940. Student B in first 1.94, in second 2.05, average 1.995 grams. Student 3 first 2.01, second 1.99, average 2.000. Addition or subtraction of significant figures. The result cannot have more digits to the right of decimal point than either of the original numbers. 12.11, 18.0, 1.012, 31.122. Here, 18.0 has only one digit after the decimal point, and the result should be reported only up to the one digit after the decimal point, which is 31.1. Multiplication and division of significant figures. In this operation, the result must be reported with no more significant figures as in the measurement with the few significant figures. 2.5 into 1.25 is equal to 3.125. Since 2.5 has two significant figures, the result should not have more than two significant figures. Thus, it is 3.1. While limiting the result to the required number of significant figures as done in the above mathematical operation, one has to keep in mind the following points for rounding of the numbers. First, if the rightmost digit to be removed is more than 5, the preceding number is increased by 1. For example, 1.386. If we have to remove 6, we have to round it to 1.39. If the rightmost digit to be removed is less than 5, the preceding number is not changed. For example, 4.334, if 4 is to be removed, then the result is rounded up to 4.33. Third, if the rightmost digit to be removed is 5, then the preceding number is not changed. If it is an even number, but it is increased by 1 if it is an odd number. For example, if 6.35 is to be rounded by removing 5, we have to increase this 3 to 4, giving 6.4 as the result. However, if 6.25 is to be rounded off, it is rounded off to 1.4.3 dimensional analysis. Often while calculating, there is a need to convert units from one system to the another. The method used to accomplish this is called factor label method or unit factor method or dimensional analysis. This is illustrated below. Example, a piece of metal is 3 inch, represented by in long. What is its length in centimeter? Solution, we know that 1 in is equal to 2.54 centimeter. From this equivalence, we can write 1 in by 2.54 centimeter is equal to 1 is equal to 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 in. Thus, 1 in is equal to 2.54 centimeter equals to 1, and 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 in also equals 1. Both of these are called unit factors. If some number is multiplied by this unit factor, that is 1, it will not be affected. Otherwise, say the 3 in the given above is multiplied by the unit factor. So, 3 in is equal to 3 in into 2.54 centimeter by 1 in is equal to 3 into 2.54 centimeter is equal to 7.62 centimeter. Now, the unit factor by which the multiplication is to be done is that unit factor. 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 in the above case, which gives the desired unit, that is the numerator should have the part which is required in the desired result. It should also be noted in the above example that units can be handled just like other numerical part. It can be cancelled, divided, multiplied, squared, etc. Let us study one more example. Example. A jug contains 2 liters of milk. Calculate the volume of milk in meter cube. Solution. Since 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, which gives 1 meter by 100 centimeter is equal to 1 is equal to 100 centimeter by 1 meter. To get meter cube from the above unit factor, the first unit factor is taken and it is cube. 1 meter divided by 100 centimeter whole cube give rise to 1 meter cube divided by 10 power 6 centimeter cube is equal to 1 meter cube is equal to 1. Now 2 liters is equal to 2 into 1000 centimeter cube. The above is multiplied by the unit factor. 2 into 1000 centimeter cube into 1 meter cube divided by 10 power 6 into centimeter cube is equal to 2 meter cube divided by 10 cube is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter cube. Example, how many seconds are there in 2 days? Solution. Here we know 1 day is equal to 24 hours h, or 1 day divided by 24 h hour is equal to 1. 24 hour divided by 1 day. Then 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, or 1 hour divided by 60 minutes is equal to 1. 60 minutes divided by 1 hour. So for converting 2 days to seconds, that is 2 days is equal to seconds. The unit factors can be multiplied in series in one step only as follows. 2 days into 24 hours divided by 1 day into 60 minutes divided by 1 hour into 60 seconds divided by 1 minute is equal to 2 into 24 into 60 seconds is equal to 172800 seconds. Loss of chemical combinations. 1.5 Laws of Chemical Combinations. The combination of elements to form compounds is governed by the following 5 basic laws. 5.1 Law of Conservation of Mass. This law was put forth by Antony Lavoisier in 1789. He performed careful experimental studies for combustion reactions and reached to the conclusion that in all physical and chemical change, there is no net change in mass during the process. Hence, he reached to conclusion that matter can neither be created nor destroyed. This is called law of conservation of mass. This law formed the basis for several later developments in chemistry. In fact, this was the result of exact measurement of masses of reactants and products and careful planned experiments performed by Lavoisier. 1.5.2 Law of definite proportions. This law was given by French chemist Joseph Proust. He stated that a given compound always contains exactly the same proportion of elements by weight. Proust worked with 2 samples of cupric carbonate, one of which was of natural origin and other was synthetic. He found that the composition of elements present in it was same for both the sample as shown below. Nature sample. Percentage of copper is equal to 51.35. Percentage of carbon is equal to 9.74. Percentage of oxygen is equal to 38.91. Synthetic sample. Percentage of copper is equal to 51.35. Percentage of carbon is equal to 9.74. Percentage of oxygen is equal to 38.98. Thus, he concluded that irrespective of the source, a given compound always contains same elements combined together in the same proportion by mass. The validity of this law has been confirmed by various experiments. It is sometimes also referred to as the law of definite composition. 1.5.3 Law of multiple proportions. This law was proposed by Dalton in 1803. According to this law, if 2 elements can combine to form more than 1 compound, the masses of one element that combine with the fixed mass of the other element are in the ratio of small whole numbers. For example, hydrogen combines with oxygen to form 2 compounds, namely water and hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen 2g plus oxygen 16g give rise to water of 18g. Hydrogen 2g plus oxygen 32g. Hydrogen peroxide is equal to 34g. Here, the masses of oxygen, that is 16 and 32g, which combine with fixed masses of hydrogen. 2g base simple ratio, that is 16:32 or 1:2. 1.54 Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volumes. This law was given by Gay-Lussac in 1808. He observed that when gases combine or are produced in a chemical reaction, they do so in a simple ratio by volume, provided all gases are at the same temperature and pressure. Thus, 100 ml of hydrogen combined with 50 ml of oxygen to give 100 ml of water vapor. Hydrogen 100 ml plus oxygen 50 ml give rise to water 100 ml. Thus, the volume of hydrogen and oxygen which combine, that is 100 ml and 50 ml, base a simple ratio 2:1. Gay-Lussac's discovery of integer ratio in volume relationship is actually the law of definite proportion by volume. The law of definite proportion stated earlier was with respect to mass. The Gay-Lussac's law was explained properly by the work of Avogadro in 1811. 1.5.5 Avogadro's law. In 1811, Avogadro proposed that equal volumes of all gases at same temperature and pressure should contain equal number of molecules. Avogadro made a distinction between atoms and molecules, which is quite understandable in present time. If considered again the reaction of hydrogen and oxygen to produce water, we see the two volumes of hydrogen combine with one volume of oxygen to give two volumes of water without leaving any undeacted oxygen. Note that in figure 1.9 page 16, each box contains equal number of molecules. In fact, Avogadro could explain the fact about the result by considering the molecules to be polyatomic if hydrogen and oxygen were considered as diatomic. As recognized now, then the above results are easily understandable. However, Dalton and others believed at that time that atoms of the same kind cannot combine, and molecules of oxygen or hydrogen containing two atoms did not exist. Avogadro's proposal was published in French journal Die Physique. In spite of being correct, it did not gain much support. After 50 years, in 1860, the first international conference on chemistry was held in Karlsruhe, Germany, to resolve various ideas at the meeting. Stanislaw Cannizzaro represented a sketch of a course of chemical philosophy which emphasized on the importance of Avogadro's work. 1.6 Dalton's atomic theory. Although the origin of idea that matter is composed of small indivisible particles called atomio, meaning indivisible, dates back to time of Democritus, a Greek philosopher, 460 to 370 BC. It again started emerging as a result of several experimental studies which led to the law mentioned above. In 1808, Dalton published a new system of chemical philosophy in which he proposed the following: one, matter consists of indivisible atoms. Two, all atoms of a given element have identical properties, including identical mass. Atoms of different elements differ in mass. 3. Compounds are formed when atoms of different elements combine in a fixed ratio. 4. Chemical reaction involves reorganization of atoms. These are neither created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. Dalton's theory could explain the laws of the chemical combination. However, it could not explain the law of gaseous volume. It could not provide the reason for combining of the atoms, which was answered later by other scientists. 1.7 Atomic and molecular masses. After having some idea about the terms atoms and molecule, it is appropriate here to understand what do we mean by atomic and molecular masses. 1.7.1 Atomic mass. The atomic mass or the mass of an atom is actually very small, because atoms are extremely small. Today we have sophisticated techniques, example mass spectrometry, for determining the atomic mass fairly accurately. But in the 19th century, scientists could determine the mass of one atom relative to another by experimental means. As has been mentioned earlier, hydrogen, being the lightest atom, was arbitrarily assigned a mass of 1 without any units, and other elements were assigned masses relative to it. However, the present system of atomic masses is based on carbon 12 as the standard and has been agreed upon in 1961. Hence, carbon 12 is one of the isotopes of carbon and can be represented as 12C. In this system, 12C is assigned a mass of exactly 12 atomic mass unit A mu, and masses of all other atoms given relative to this standard. Atomic mass unit is defined as a mass exactly equal to 1/12 of the mass of one carbon 12 atoms, and 1 AMU is equal to 1.66056 × 10⁻²⁻⁴ gram. mass of an atom of hydrogen is equal to 1.6736 into 10 to the power of minus 24 gram. Thus, in terms of AMU, the mass of hydrogen atom is equal to 1.6736 into 10 to the power of minus 24 gram divided by 1.6056 into 10 to the power of minus 24 gram is equal to 1.0078 AMU is equal to 1.0080 AMU. Similarly, the mass of oxygen 16O atom would be 15.995 AMU. At present, AMU has been replaced by U, which is known as unified mass. When we use atomic mass of elements in calculation, we actually use average atomic masses of elements, which are explained below. 1.7.2 Average atomic mass. Many naturally occurring elements exist as more than one isotope, which we take into account the existence of these isotopes and their relative abundance percent occurrence. The average atomic mass of that element can be computed. For example, carbon has the following three isotopes with relative abundance and masses as shown against. Isotope relative abundance percentage atomic mass in 12C. Relative abundance 98.892 atomic mass 12. 13C 1.108 atomic mass 13.00335. 14C relative abundance 2 into 10 to the power of minus 10 atomic mass 14.00317. each of them. From the above data, the average atomic mass of the carbon will come out to be 0.98892 into 12U plus 0.01108 into 13.00335U plus 2 into the 10 to the power of minus 12 into 14.00317U is equal to 12.011U. Similarly, average atomic masses for other elements can be calculated in the periodic table of elements. The atomic masses mentioned for different elements actually represent their average atomic masses. Molecular mass is the sum of atomic masses of the elements present in a molecule. It is obtained by multiplying the atomic mass of each element by the number of its atoms and adding them together. For example, molecular mass of methane, which contains one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms, can be obtained as follows. Molecular mass of methane. CH4 is equal to 12.011U plus 4 into 1.008U is equal to 16.043U. Similarly, molecular mass of water, H2O, is equal to 2 into atomic mass of hydrogen plus 1 into atomic mass of oxygen is equal to 2 into 1.008U plus 16.00U is equal to 18.02U. 1.7.4 Formula mass. Some substances such as sodium chloride do not contain discrete molecules as their constituent units. In such compounds, positive sodium ion and negative chloride ion entities are arranged in a three-dimensional structure as shown in figure 1.10. Figure 1.10, packing of Na plus and Cl minus ions in sodium chloride. It may be noted that in sodium chloride, one Na plus ion is surrounded by six chlorine minus ion and vice versa. The formula such as NaCl is used to calculate the formula mass instead of molecular mass as in the solid state. Sodium chloride does not exist as a single entity. Thus, the formula mass of sodium chloride, atomic mass of sodium plus atomic mass of chloride is equal to 23.0U plus 35.5U is equal to 58.5U. 1.8 Mole concept and molecular masses. Atoms and molecules are extremely small in size, and the numbers in even smaller amount of any substance is really very large. To handle such large numbers, a unit of convenient magnitude is required. Just as we denote 1 dozen for 12 items, core for 20 items, gloss for 144 items, we use the idea of mole to count entities at the microscopic level, that is atom, molecules, particles, electrons, ions, etc. In SI system, mole, single mole was introduced as 7th base quantity for the amount of a substance. 1 mole is the amount of a substance that contains as many particles or entities as there are atoms in exactly 12 gram or 0.012 kg of the 12C isotope. It may be emphasis that the mole of a substance always contain the same number of entities. No matter what the substance may be in order to the determine this number previously, the mass of a carbon 12 atom was determined by a mass spectrometer and found to be equal to 1.992648 × 10⁻³ gram. Knowing that 1 mole of carbon weighs 12 gram, the number of atoms in it is equal to 12 gram by mole, 12 gram per mole 12C divided by 1.992648 × 10⁻²⁷ gram per 12C atom is equal to 6.022136 × 10⁻³ atoms per mole. The number of entities in 1 mole is important that it is given a separate name and symbol. It is known as Avogadro's constant or Avogadro's number, denoted by Na in honor of Amedeo Avogadro, to appreciate the largeness of this number. Let us write it with all the zeros without using any powers of 10. 6022136700000000000000000. Hence, so many entities, atoms, molecules, or any other particle constitute 1 mole of a particular substance. We can therefore see that 1 mole of hydrogen atoms is equal to 6.022 × 10⁻²⁰ atoms. 1 mole of water molecules is equal to 6.022 × 10⁻²³ water molecules. 1 mole of sodium chloride is equal to 6.022 × 10⁻²³ formula units of sodium chloride. Having defined the mole, it is easier to know the mass of 1 mole of a substance or the constituent entities. The mass of 1 mole of a substance is grams, is called its molar mass. The molar mass in grams is numerically equal to atomic molecular formula mass in U. Molar mass of water is equal to 18.02 gram mole inverse. Molar mass of sodium chloride is equal to 58.5 gram mole minus 1. 1.9 percentage composition. So far we were dealing with the number of entities present in a given sample. But many a time, information regarding the percentage of a particular element present in a compound is required. Suppose an unknown or a new compound is given to you, the first question you would ask is, what is the formula or what are its constituents and in what ratio are they present in the given compound? For known compounds also, such information provides a check whether the given sample contains the same percentage of elements as percentage in the pure sample. In other words, one can check the purity of a given sample by analyzing this data. Let us understand it by taking the example of water, H2O. Since water contains hydrogen and oxygen, the percentage composition of both these elements can be calculated as follows. Mass percentage of an element. Mass of the element in the compound into 100 by molar mass of the compound. molar mass of the compound is equal to 18.02 gram. Mass percentage of hydrogen is equal to 2 into 1.008 divided by 18.02 into 100 is equal to 11.18. Mass percentage of oxygen 16.00 divided by 18.02 into 100 is equal to 88.79. Let us take one more example. What is the percentage of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen in ethanol? Molecular formula of ethanol is C2H5OH. Molecular mass of ethanol is 2 into 12.01 plus 6 into 1.008 plus 16.00 gram is equal to 46.068 gram. Mass percent of carbon is equal to 24.02 gram divided by 46068 gram into 100 is equal to 52.14%. Mass percent of hydrogen 6.048 gram divided by 46.068 gram into 100 is equal to 13.13%. Mass percent of oxygen 16.00 gram divided by 46.068 gram into 100 is equal to 4.73%. After understanding the calculation of percent of mass, let us now see what information can be obtained from the percent composition of data. 1.9.1 Empirical formula for molecular formula. An empirical formula represents the simplest whole number ratio of various atoms present in a compound, whereas the molecular formula shows the exact number of different types of atoms present in a molecule of a compound. If the mass percent of various elements present in a compound is known, its empirical formula can be determined. Molecular formula can be further be obtained if the molecular mass is known. The following example illustrates this sequence. 1.10 Stoichiometry and stoichiometric calculations. The word stoichiometry is derived from two Greek words, stoichion, meaning element, and metron, meaning measure. Stoichiometry thus deals with the calculation of masses, sometimes volumes also, of the reactants and the products involved in a chemical reaction. Before understanding how to calculate the amounts of reactants required or the products produced in a chemical reaction, let us study what information is available from the balance chemical equation of a given reaction. Let us consider the conversion of methane. A balanced equation for this reaction is as given below. CH4 gram plus 2O2 gram give rise to CO2 gram plus 2H2O gram. Here methane and dioxygen are called reactants and carbon dioxide and water are called products. Note that all the reactants and the products are gases in the above reaction, and this has been indicated by letter in the brackets next to its formula. Similarly, in case of solids and liquids, S and L are written respectively. The coefficients 2 for O2 and H2O are called stoichiometric coefficients. Similarly, the coefficients for CH4 and CO2 is 1 in each case. They represent the number of molecules and moles as well, taking part in the reaction or formed in the reaction. Thus, according to the above chemical reaction, 1 mole of CH4 gram reacts with 2 moles of O2 gram to give 1 mole of CO2 gram and 2 moles of H4O gram and 2 moles of H2O gram. 1 molecule of CH4 gram reacts with 2 molecules of O2 gram to give 1 molecule of CO2 gram and 2 molecules of H2O gram. 22.7 liter of CH4 gram reacts with 45.4 liter of O2 grams to give to 22.7 liter of CO2 gram and 45.4 liter of H2O gram. 16 gram of CH4 gram reacts with 2 into 32 gram of O2 gram to give 44 gram of CO2 g and 2:18 gram of H2O gram. From these relationships, the given data can be interconverted as follows. Mass give rise to molecules, molecules give rise to number of moles, number of moles give rise to moles, mole give rise to mass. Mass by volume is equal to density. 1.10.1 Limiting reagent. Many a time reactions are carried out with the amounts of reactants that are different than the amounts as required by a balanced chemical reaction. In such situation, one reactant is in more amount than the amount required by a balanced chemical reaction. The reactant which is present in the least amount gets consumed after some time, and after that further reaction does not take place whatever be the amount of the other reactant. Hence the reactant which gets consumed first limits the amount of product formed and is therefore called the limiting reagent. In the performing stoichiometric calculation, this aspect is also to be kept in mind. 1.10.2 Reaction in solutions. A majority of reactions in the laboratories are carried out in solutions. Therefore, it is important to understand as how the amount of substances is expressed when it is present in the solution. The concentration of a solution of the amount of substance present in it given the volume can be expressed in any of the following ways. 1. Mass percent or weight percent, W by W percent. 2. Mole fraction. 3. Molarity. 4. Molality. Let us now study each one of them in detail. First, mass percent. It is obtained by using the following reaction. Mass percent is equal to mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100. Second, mole fraction. It is the ratio of number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of the solution. If a substance A dissolves in the substance B and the number of the moles are in A and NB respectively, then the mole fractions of A and B are given as mole fraction of A is equal to number of moles of A divided by number of moles of solution is equal to NA divided by NA plus NB. Mole fraction of B is equal to number of moles of B divided by number of moles of solution is equal to NB divided by NA plus NB. Third, molarity. It is the most widely used unit and is denoted by M. It is defined as the number of moles of the solute in 1 liter of the solution. Thus, molarity M is equal to number of moles of solute, volume of solution in liters. Suppose we have 1 molarity solution of a substance, say NaOH, and we want to prepare a 0.2 molarity solution from it. 1 molarity NaOH means 1 mole of NaOH present in 1 liter of the solution. For 0.2 molarity solution, we require 0.2 moles of NaOH dissolved in 1 liter solution. Hence, for making 0.2 molarity solution from 1 molarity solution, we have to take the volume of 1 molarity NaOH solution which contains 0.2 mole of NaOH and dilute the solution with water to 1 liter. Now, how much volume of concentrated 1 molarity NaOH solution be taken which contains 0.2 moles of NaOH can be calculated as follows. If 1 mole is present in 1 liter or 1000 ml solution, then 0.2 mole is present in 1000 ml divided by 1 mole into 0.2 mole solution is equal to 200 ml solution. Thus, 200 ml of 1 molarity NaOH are taken and enough water is added to dilute it to make it 1 liter. In fact, for such calculations, a general formula M1 into V1 is equal to M2 into V2, where M and V are molarity and volume respectively can be used In this case, M1 is equal to 0.2 molarity, V1 is equal to 1000 ml, and molarity 2, and M2 is equal to 0.1 molarity. V2 is to be calculated, substituting the values in the formula. 0.2 molarity into 1000 ml is equal to 1.0 molarity into V2. Therefore, V2 is equal to 0.2 m into 1000 ml divided by 1.0 m is equal to 200 liter. Note that the number of moles of solute NaOH was 0.2 in 200 ml and has remained the same, that is 0.2 even after dilution in 1000 ml. As we changed just the amount of solvent, that is water, and have not done anything with respect to NaOH. But keep in mind the concentration. Molality. For molality, it is defined as the number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. It is denoted by M. Thus, molality small m is equal to number of moles of solute divided by mass of solvent in kg.
Thank you for being till the end. I hope this has helped you. If so, give thumbs up, like, share, comment, save, download and subscribe. You can support us by following in other platforms. That link is in the description. Well, thank you. See you later. Maybe never.